Hey everyone, look what we have here. You can see way down the road there. You see that water starting to flood into the street? I can tell that crosses the street during big floods, and it's all caused by the culvert up here. We unclogged this back in the spring, but obviously times have changed. I have to figure out where it is. It looks like this may be why. In the spring, there was a big metal grate that I was pulling grass off of, but I don't see the grate. Maybe it fell backwards and the beavers clogged up inside it. I honestly, in order to figure out where it is, I gotta look on the other side. I don't even know if this is uncloggable because it looks like it's really bad. I don't know where the metal grate is. Highly doubt out here, 90 miles away from the nearest civilization, anyone stole it. Okay, that's the pipe there. Corrugated galvanized pipe. The bottom is rusty, but not rusted out. The oil you're seeing in the water is natural from the swamp. Oh, actually, right here. See the cracking in the ground? That's from yesterday it rained. Today it's baking in the sun, drying out. As the road dries out, it shrinks and sinks. Can't do that where the pipe is, so it cracks. It's going across diagonally right here. Oh, stupid me. I didn't see it. There's the metal grate right here. See it? Oh yeah, we can definitely unclog this. Definitely. How easy is that gonna be? Oh, that's gonna be super easy. Let's get the rake out and watch the whole swamp draw back. No, actually, I'd rather do this one with my hands. I think that would be much more productive. We're out in the middle of nowhere. I'm not worried about needles. Not worried about finding a fish hook either. No one's gonna fish in this little swamp hole. I'm gonna do that by hand. Get a bunch of that out of there, pull the grate up, pick it clean. This whole swamp's gonna drain back. This, yeah, that's beaver related, definitely. This is gonna go fast. Can't budge the grate, the beaver dam against it's too much, so I don't even know if I'll be able to get that out. Surging on the other side. And you saw that's not a big pipe. I'm only gonna open it the diameter of the pipe. And you know, beavers, they'll be back tonight and they'll block it immediately. No way to prevent that. They need a beaver-proof structure here where it's gonna keep flooding and crossing the street over the top. See that? Hands almost get stuck against it. That's what you call delta P. If this was a bigger structure, wouldn't it be safe to go near it? Just checking my leg, make sure there's no leeches on it. This is a really swampy muck hole. The beaver dam's actually pretty strong. I'm gonna stand right here, get a better angle. We're gonna go for a drive and come back here in an hour as soon as I feel satisfied with this. Yeah, we're not gonna be able to get that off. But I am gonna open it fully the diameter of the pipe. Checking for leeches. And there's not that much pressure here. Just an, ooh, what was that? Oh, it's just a tree branch. paranoid about the leeches coming out because this is a real swampy area. Surprised I don't see any around me. Now this here, this feels kind of cool putting my hands against that pressure. Now if this pipe was maybe 2 more feet down, that's kind of dangerous, like a drowning hazard, because there'd be so much more current against it. But here, it's pretty harmless this time. Yeah, they can't have a flat grate like this. This is like a beaver's dream. They'll come over here tonight and clog in like 10 minutes. Guaranteed. All right, that's as much as we're gonna get. That's probably draining. The size of the pipe I saw. The grate is actually diminishing a little bit of its flow. Factor that in. I'd say, well, first look at the other side, but probably between 5,000 and 8,000 gallons a minute. Because this size culvert at full capacity is more like, I think, 10,000 per minute. But it has to be put in perfectly, and it has to get a siphon going to do that. There's no way a siphon's going in. Like right now, I'm pouring in probably 80% coming in. Other side, it's probably only gonna be like half coming out because the water's speeding up. Oh yeah, look at the other side. Let's get a shot of before. And after. Whoa, we made a big difference here today. Oh, I was close, not 50%, maybe 40%. That's a lot of current coming out. Beavers are not gonna be happy. They're gonna hear this noise, they're gonna notice a drop in water, and they're gonna be out as soon as the sun comes down, and they'll block in like 10 minutes. What they're gonna do is, from the bottom of the pond, they're just gonna push mud and all the junk and slime grass back against it, and it'll be plugged instantly. Got some great current coming out. Get a closer look. Oh, no. Ooh, muddy here. That is some strong flow. Whoa, look at my hand. I love to feel that current. And as I'm touching it, there's rocks and stuff tumbling through that. So it's actually digging itself open a little more as we talk. All right. So you see that water down here? That will go away if the beavers don't undo this. I'd say this culvert is stupidly undersized, but, and this is a main artery. It's not like they're putting in a temporary pipe. This is permanent. Now that the ground is clear up, you can see the big divot I made now that the water has cleared. That's a lot of current coming through. Beavers will clog that real fast. This pipe is too small. It should be more like a 3-foot pipe with a beaver-proof structure around it. I found the best structure. You go out a little bit and it's a big cone. No fencing or anything. It just pours into it really smooth. Doesn't make much noise. The beavers don't really hear it. And they don't really know how to clog it either. I've seen those work in wildlife sanctuaries. Flawless. Out here, the loggers tend to put a big fence around it. Which does slow them down. It works. But it still needs to be maintained probably every few weeks. Or it will have the same problem. Looking along the edge, we don't see any leeches. This looks like definitely their habitat. Very surprised not to see any. None. Surprising. This looks like a former beaver lodge. See right in here? Definitely a beaver lodge at some point. Let's come down here, look around. That's discharging thousands of gallons a minute. We got moose tracks here. So hopefully when we come back, these little puddles here will have receded. And as you can see, there's no drainage ditch anymore. It's about due to be digged out. All right, so this will go down pretty soon. Down here is what alerted me of the problem. I was like, why is all this water here? Then when I get up there a few hundred yards further down the street, I'm like, hey, we were here in the spring. This wasn't a problem back then. Wasn't even clogged, but I did some preventative maintenance by removing what was on it at the time. Yep. So this is what we're gonna do here. See this nice big rack? We're gonna roll this right here. Yep. That's marking the edge of the water so we can see how far we drop back. We'll be back here in about 1 hour. Only expect it to go down maybe an inch or two. It's a small pipe, and that's probably millions of gallons of water throughout that swamp. Beavers are beneficial to the environment, but you gotta know how to work with them as a culvert installer. This right here, I don't even know what the purpose of this is, because a natural clog would form and block the end, sticks would get stuck and it would build, no problem, no grate required. The only way I can see this grate actually helping is so the beaver doesn't build inside. Sometimes they'll build in the middle because I don't think they learn that people can't get to it easy. It's just, they just decide to do that sometimes. It's usually on the end, but sometimes it's a pain in the butt to do inside. And a lot of times they'll have to jet the culvert. And you can see some of these rocks occasionally let loose. That's what I was feeling on the other side when I put my hand in the water. I kept getting hit by little rocks. It's this. It sucks them in and comes out the other side like little bullets. Getting windy out. Look at that pollinator holding on to the goldenrod as we have these strong winds. This has got to be an ongoing problem because you see how they keep coming in here with machines occasionally. Some of those still have leaves. They're dead. I'd say that's about 3 or 4 weeks since that tree was killed by them coming in here. So it's an ongoing problem. You see, there's no trees growing here. They're constantly having to bring machines here. They know about this. But beaver, they'll clog it up overnight. So it's an ongoing thing. Like, they'll come here, unclog it, let it drain back. Beaver will put the dam back the same night. It probably takes a while for this water to build back also. So that's why it's manageable. All right, it's time to pull over and take on fuel. Always have to bring a couple tanks of gas with me to get out to these places because I won't be able to get back on the same tank. I just tested. I wanted to see if the car would go into negative numbers. It does not. When it gets to zero on the range, it doesn't go down anymore. Cars always carry a few extra gallons below E, so it's not like it's going to burn out the fuel pump driving a few miles beyond zero, because usually in a modern vehicle, it'll probably go between 50 and 70 beyond zero. Well, it does not go below zero. Doesn't read below zero. Let's fuel up. There we go. Bring 6 of these cans with me. The vehicle takes about 2 1/4 to completely fill up. All right, we're heading back. It'll be about 90 minutes when we get back. About what I said, it's okay to go a few miles underneath your range, but don't push it going that 50 miles under your range. That's a good way to burn out your fuel pump. But also, when you go down that low, you're going to a part of the tank that doesn't always get used, and there's going to be like sludge and stuff that's more likely to get sucked over to the pump and clog it up if you go down that low. Pulling on back up. Oh yeah, we dropped a lot. That big puddle in the road up there is almost gone. Yep, this water's all dropping back and it's gonna continue to do that. Yep, look at that. See the puddle? It's draining back into the pond. Look at it, it's all draining now as it's heading over to that culvert. Now let's go take a look at that rock. Oh, it dropped back more than I expected. Remember, I said like 1 or 2 inches. probably an elevation 2 inches so far, but considering what I meant, it's more like 5 inches or so. And it's gonna continue to do that all night until this is gone. A ranger just questioned me and he was happy with my answer. All right, yes, we did drop back and you can even see the evidence now. Before it was like up here. Yeah, it's dropping back. This here, I'd say, has actually dropped back maybe 6 inches or so. Yeah, maybe. Over there, it's not as noticeable because it has to slowly trickle out of those puddles. So you've got a little bit of debris built back against here, just floating over. But like I said, the beavers are gonna really jam that up tonight. You see, it's not as violent of a torrent now. Let's go see what's on the other side. It's definitely settling down. Yes, it is settling down. And you see the water's nice and clean now. It has cleared up. It's definitely calming down. Surprised to see in the main pond we dropped 5 or 6 inches. Further down, it's not as noticeable in the puddles. Yep, we're drawing back. Because what happens here, what's important is in the winter, doesn't really matter now, but in the winter, when you have water this, like, there's not much elevation here, this entire thing is acting like a dam, and it's waterlogged. So in the winter, what happens is the surface of the road freezes while there's water still underneath it. And as it continues to freeze down, at some point, that ice can't push down anymore, so it starts lifting the road up. You'll see cracks, and you'll suddenly be driving, it's like, whoom, driving off a few inch ramp. It's called frost heaves. It can also cause big rocks that you don't see right now to start pushing their way up through the top. These roads are perfect now because it's the end of summer, but come out here in the spring, you'll be twisting and turning around all kinds of rocks that were pushed up during the winter in these swampy areas. These roads are impassable to a car and small SUVs in the spring. Now, basically anything can drive out here if you're careful. There are still a few violent potholes that come out of nowhere, but it's pretty good now. Hope this video was interesting. Thanks for watching.